Morning, guys. Am I audible?
Yes,
Yes.
sir. One, sir.
Morning. Okay, so I'll move forward from here, and this time I'm just going to compose some of the element here. Okay, so I'll just remove this. Okay, to begin with, let's say I want to add a different plate here. Like I want to remove the paper and add something different. So for that, we can start adding a background here. I have this footage here, so we're gonna use this one. And for this, I'll just import this whole footage. Okay, I'll take this image as a reference. So all I'm doing is just extracting this area. I do not want the sky area to be there. So just put a roto and I'll apply a premult node. Then I will add a card. Okay, now before you adding a card, what I will do, I'll go to the scene again, directly to the scene. And I can just go to the camera tracker, double click it. So I can get those points here. Now, if you're not able to see, that means that I have switched off the render. I'll just go to the solid so I can see them. Okay, so I have to move my viewer from here to there. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to place my image exactly at this position. So what I'm trying to do is, I'm trying to get some green points selected here. So select some green points here. Holding control. So the floor just line ups with it. So I'm just trying to get as many as green point possible. I won't be taking this because this is at a different space. Okay, this is where I want to create the card. Right click, create card. Go to the 3D space, there will be card. Now obviously it's not lining up, so we have to line up that by rotating. The card, and I'll come here and I'll just go to the card option. Okay, so I'll just play with it and see which direction I want to rotate this. So I'm getting some values here. I think this should be zero. No, not zero. This should be 90, I guess. Okay, and then we have to play with this value here. I'm just holding control and I'm rotating it. And just make sure when you're rotating this card, try bringing the card little up, not below the grid line. It should be little up. If it's below, it will float. Card up ka float hoga yahan pe. So if I go back to the tab option, you can see the card here. So it's not lining up, so I might have to play with the rotation here. And why it's looking black? Because I haven't applied any texture to it. So that's why it's looking black. So I'll take this image, connect it here. Okay, to move around, we can always apply a transform node And then you can use the translate. We can always use the projection mode, but right now we haven't done any projection, so. And don't worry about key how it's looking, it will get fixed. Gonna add some displacement node, and so I'm just trying changing the value here. I need to scale the image also. So I need to shift the card, or what I will do? Okay, I'll just try to shift. I just don't want floats here. And then I'm going to just rotate it. It's in the, I guess, in the wrong direction, I guess. So I'll put it minus 180 degrees. Plus. Put 360. Okay. So once I've done, I can again go back to the point cloud and go to the render option and switch it off. So let's just play and see if it's lining up or not. That is sliding. Yeah, I think it's doing a quite good job. We can bring this little bit this side also, but overall it is sticking with the surface of our book. That's fine. Like that. So this way once more. So see if it's sliding. I guess it is sliding a bit. Let it play once. I guess it's sliding at the very beginning here, and that can be possible. That is happening because, let's see, our grid is, I'll select this, just try to push little bit up. Whenever something is happening like this, just try to bring your card just above the grid line. That should fix it. So if I just play again, I'm just watching this. I think the starting footage is already floating. That's why it's happening. Let's see. Let's compose the dinosaur and we'll see later. So say overall, I am done for this ground right now. I'm going to use some displace geo. I think the name is displace geo only. Displace geo. So with that, what you can do is, I think this is to display and this is for this. Okay. So with this, what you can do is, if I come here, you can see something has happened. So what I did exactly, I gave him the image key, which image I want to displace and which card I want to display. So I set this one, and here I can come here and I can start increasing the displace. So it will create some mountain type of effect, train effect. And so if you are not getting a good effect right now, what you can do is go to the card And there is a row and columns here. So just in, I know you guys know from the Maya. So I'll just increase the row and column from 60-60. So you can get some more details to the trains. And when you can go back to the scale value, you can drop some. This is just to add some detail here. It looks like a zigzag area rather than completely flatted plane. Okay, I can go back to the card. Don't go above 100 if you have a low configuration. I'll make it like 40 by 40. So I just want little more subtle detail, not that much. Okay, we can go in minus also. Yes. Not that much. Okay, say overall I am happy with this. Let's go and composite the dinosaur over this footage. Okay, I'll go with the primate. This is the easiest one. Batana. I'll just go with this one and I'll just do an auto compute. It will directly do 90% of job for me. And if it's spelling too much, you guys can go and spill minus it. Or a spill plus it. So I just want the natural colors to come up. Okay. And then I take a card because I want this to be in 3D. Okay. Now, again, for the card, what you can do is I'll just delete the card and I'll go back to this scanline render. Say, I'll come back to the camera tracker. I want the point. Say I want the dinosaurs to be here, so I'll select this, right click, create a card. So it will be this dinosaur will directly be on that card only. So it's a very easy way to start. Okay, why am I seeing a black patch here? Okay, so I'll connect this to the scene. Okay, so I'll come back here and connect this to the viewer. Okay, so I don't know why there is a black patch coming in the 3D. It should not be there. But nevertheless, so I can come back here and if I press tab. Okay, so you can see that the dinosaur feet is going down the grid line. As I already told you, starting with Arakam, it should always be popping up above the grid line, should not be below. If it's below, you're gonna see some slides happening, sliding happening. So I'll just drop this and don't worry about this text, we can fix it later. Okay, so let's play. Okay, now in this case, as you can see, it feels like the dinosaur is running on a treadmill. वो एक ही जगह पे रुका हुआ है ऐसा लग रहा है. Yeah, somebody वो anyone want to say something? Okay, and the footage length is also just 70 frames. So, okay, as you can see, it looks like it's running on a treadmill. So, what you guys can do is you can animate the card, so it does not feel like, meaning, what I will do, I'll take the card and you can see a translate here. So I'll set a key and say the animation is of say 70 frame only. Second, what I can do, I just can move the card. I'm just creating a fake. This is not a 3D, this is a 2D. So now you can see it will just give you a fake illusion that the dinosaur is moving forward. Okay, now we have another problem. We were able to see this text here. So to remove that, you can always use a roto node. Okay, apply a pre-melt node. Okay, so this has become opaque. What I'll do is just select this Control X and I'll apply after pre-melt node. I'll go to the roto node, go to the alpha and make it black. Some shadows will be killed here, so you have to live with that. Okay, so once I've done with this, I'll go back here. कोई क्वेश्चन है गाइस?
नो सर.
बन जाएगा?
हाँ सर.
ओके, मैं आप लोग के साथ कुछ और एलिमेंट 3D के वीडियो शेयर करता हूँ. सॉरी, यहाँ पे लगता है एक फ्रेम कहीं पे ही हो गया. से अगर आपको इस डायनासोर की वीडियो को थोड़ा फास्ट या स्लो करना है, let me see if I remember time. I guess time, I already told you about that thing, is called time warp. Say let's see if this footage ka timing kya hai. So I'll put input so I can get the timing. So it's 76 frame, but I want ki kahin pe ek frame yahan pe kharab ho gaya, corrupt ho gaya, so you will be seeing a red error here. So ignore that ek frame kahin corrupt ho gaya hai. But again, coming back to the time warp, say मान लेते 70 frame है and मेरे को क्या करना है, इसका length बढ़ाना है. So I want कि ये 140 हो जाए. वीडियो को स्लो करना है. So I can come to the 70 frame and make this as a 140. No, it won't take it out 140. Input frame. Okay, it can only degrade it, but it won't make. I'll give you a different option. Now it's actually trying to shrink the video, but isko speed up kar de raha hai, lekin isko slow nahi kar raha. But let's say ki 70 frame tak hi aapko karna hai, so you just do that 70 frame only. Yahan pe pata nahi kya ho gaya. Okay, let's do the, what is it, put a render of 75 frame only. ज़्यादा मत निकाला, 75 frame ही रख लेना. I'll go to the settings and I'll make it 75. I'll tell you how to do that. Time warp को कैसे change करते हैं in next class. But फिलहाल आप लोग इतना ही कर लो इसको अभी यहाँ पे. Okay, कुछ और elements अगर आपको add करने हैं, for example if I take a read geo here, से आपने कुछ माया वगैरह में बना रखा है और उसको आप call करना चाहते हो, so you can use the read geo node. Go to the file option and I'll go to the direct. Let me see. Let me find the location. Okay.
Okay, sir.
ये पूरा complete हो जाएगा. हो जाएगा नहीं होगा?
हाँ हो जाएगा सर, आज ही हो जाएगा.
कौन है? Oh my God, Rikesh, चल तू आज करके दे दे. तेरे को मैं पांच ना मार्क्स एक्स्ट्रा दूंगा, चल 10 दूंगा, तू कंप्लीट करके दिखा बस।
ओके सर।
ओके सो अगर आपसे ना कि आप कुछ उस डायनासोर को पॉपुलेट करना चाहते हो, जस्ट व्हाट आई डिड कि मैंने डुप्लीकेट कर दिया है, आप एक सिंगल कार्ड से भी कर सकते थे, बट नेवरदलेस सो आई जस्ट गो टू टॉप प्रेसिंग एफ। सो ये जैसे डायनासोर के इसके खुद के चाइल्ड सम सो मैंने जस्ट उस कार्ड को डुप्लीकेट करके जस्ट
तो सर कुछ बोल रहा है।
हाँ सर बता,
पूछ रहा था चैट्स।
अच्छा उसका ऑडियो नहीं आ रहा क्या? चल मैं देखता हूँ, आई विल सी योर चैट इन अ सेकंड सर, आई एम जस्ट ट्राइंग टू कंपोजिट दिस फर्स्ट एंड देन आई विल सी। ओके सो आई विल जस्ट रिमूव द एनिमेशन फ्रॉम हियर, सो फर्स्ट आई एम गोइंग टू डू नो एनिमेशन, आई विल ब्रिंग दिस tiny dinosaur up in front. See again, I'm not rotating. In your scene, it you might have to rotate your dinosaur depending on ki tumne kis tarah se track kiya. Okay, so put it something like this, or I'll put it little far here. All I'm doing is just playing with the cards right now, so trying to compose it. Okay, say somewhere around here, and then again what you need, I need to do is set key, I'll move to 75 frames, 74 frames to where, and I'll move it. So it's moving, it's not pausing at the same place. ओके सो इन नेक्स्ट क्लास वी विल सी हाउ टू क्रिएट द शैडो, से कि अगर आपको इसके शैडोज वगैरह बनाने तो आप कैसे क्रिएट कर सकते हो, वी विल सी दैट नेक्स्ट क्लास। आप यूट्यूब से जाके डिफरेंट डायनासोर के वीडियोस डाउनलोड कर सकते हैं, क्रोमा के अवेलेबल हैं, सो आप डिफरेंट डिफरेंट अगर यूज करना चाहते हैं यू कैन यूज दैट ऑल्सो। ओके सो दीज आर सम वेरी कूल इफेक्ट्स यू कैन क्रिएट विद द 3D मोशन ट्रैकिंग, 3D मोशन ट्रैकिंग। आगे हम लोग देखेंगे भी नेक्स्ट 2-3 क्लास में और भी कुछ कूल इफेक्ट्स बनाएंगे। रही बात सौरभ की, सो वेलकम बैक टू सौरभ।